Now I gotta prep this again for cross cutting. Yeah. Forgot to turn on the vacuum, so sawdust everywhere. Okay, now probably use this end, so I'll cut this area off. This board is really weird. Board is gonna give me a hard time. I can sense it. I can feel it. Just cut that off. What I mean? Move here, move there, move that, move this. Every time I move it, I have a risk of damaging it. Okay, now just have to cut it a little wider than what I need it to be. Or not, just cut it to that size and call it a day. That would be a better option. Looking at 10:38. 10:38. Okay. 10:38. We'll use this side. Is not the blade for this, but I don't care right now. Ten 38, not 13:38. 10:38. Double check. Yep, 10:38. And it was off. I'm not gonna cry about this. I'm not gonna cry about that. Just keep it like that. Pretty close. Is it perfect? I don't care. You are a back. Welcome back. I hate this machine with a passion. It is so poorly optimized. Thank you. Okay. Welcome in. Okay, we're there. Now this, we can now make all the grooves. I need to make sure I avoid this corner here because it is blown out. But essentially this will arch like that and end maybe somewhere around here on both ends. So we can start routing stuff. What do I start with? We can start with the smaller stuff, I believe. All these long pieces need to have a slot cut into them. So we'll do the slots first, and then we'll do the tongues, or the grooves, or whatever they're called. Where are the other pieces? I believe this is the other piece. So we have our, yeah, this is the same one. So all of these need a groove. Let's start grooving. Got my router table. My amazing router table here. Really don't need the fence, but I'll keep it on there. Now I want to measure out where the center of this is, mark it out. So we have 30 millimeters. That's 15 millimeters is the center. Let me just, I had the pencil with me. I brought it in. Now to find it again. Should be here, but it's not. What about over here? Yes, it is. Okay, so half of that would be 15 millimeters would be the halfway point. Double check. It's just a little off, I believe. That's okay. Does it have to be perfect? No, it does not. It does not have to be perfect. Okay, I always mark this on the wrong spot. Should mark it here on the face. Because I'm going to butt this up to the fence. Let's draw a straight line through that. This might not be the best option, but that's where my slot is supposed to go. Oh, it's okay. He's kind of a handful, but, you know, cats will be cats. Do I have any scrap of this? I do, I believe. If I have a scrap, I can make a test cut. I believe this is scrap. He's a bit of a wild cat. He loves to eat the other cat's food. So there's that. If he sleeps with us, he starts biting our toes like at 3 a.m. And a little bit of a handful. He's just as gluttonous as the other cat. The other cat mellowed down, Neko mellowed down, but he is at his full potential of just being a douchebag. So, yeah. So we got 12 millimeters off of this side, and we have 12 millimeters there. So we're good. Okay, so let's just make a test cut here. It's pretty straightforward. No ifs, ands, or buts. It's just looks good. There is a little bit of a, it pushes out a little bit, which is good. That means that the bearing, why is it catching? It's catching because it's on the other side. It might be off by just a tad bit, and it kind of pinches. But yeah, the bearing is making contact, which is what I want. Okay, we're good. So let's just make sure we identify all the faces that need to be routed out, because I don't want to route out the wrong edge. Don't want to do something stupid now. This only has the pencil marks. It's the wider side. Okay, we got that done. 4, 5, 6, and we're still missing these two. Again, this side. And either one of these. Oh, wait, no, not either one. I have to make sure I don't include the blown out edge. So this is the edge that's going to get routed out. And I'm only routing this end here, even though it's going to get cut out, because of the ends will receive a piece with a tongue like that. So I need to route out the flat area first, and then we can do the other side. Okay, let's just start this. I'm going to put on the vacuum, because this will make a lot of sawdust. I was just looking at that. Let's just plug this in here real quick. You can plug in the shop vac to this, which is another screeching machine. But it is better to have this on than not. That was not great. I could add a wedge there and call it, because I'm not going to fuss too much over this. No. This is not the right way to do this. I already messed this up. Okay. If anything, I still have more material I can cut another piece, but let's just put it off to the side. I'm gonna grab my plunge router. Let's remove it out of the router base, and we'll use the other base for this. Forget about dust collection then. I'm not going to take that apart to put it back together. Just going to grab something else. I can't use a palm router because palm router does not have a half inch chuck, so So I have a proper router table. I'm not gonna use this anymore. Okay, that's close enough. Let's plug this in. We'll have to prop something up here so we can route this out without it moving around. It's not gonna be this, that's for sure. I'll just do a couple of these like that on the side as a spacer. We'll clamp them down to the bench. That way we have some clearance. Will I be able to put a clamp on it, though? Let's see. I think I can. I have to bring it all the way out to the edge. Because the bit does extend far out of the piece that I'm going to be routing, so it has to overhang just a little bit on every side. Let's clamp these down and then we can route it out. This could go well or horrible. Well or horribly wrong. You know what? I have my mark here. I can Yeah, that looks good enough. Okay. Let's go. There's so much stuff in the way. There's always stuff in the way. Okay, now switch this one out. Did the same thing here. At least with these long ones, some of them are not visible. At least won't be visible. I'll just shim it with some little piece of scrap of wood. There's a problem with hand routing things. Okay, now for the tongue. I'm gonna put all of these over there again, and I don't think I'm gonna cut anything super soon. I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hot glue some scraps in line with the pieces so that the groove can start and end without me, you know, misfiring like I have right now here. Should have done the same thing. Did not think I would need it here. But I'm tired and I'm losing control of my movements. That's never a good thing. So that's gonna go there. Okay. Now all the other teeny tiny pieces that I needed, where are they? They're just spread around all over the shop here. I should do these first. These are the actual pieces of the frame. I'm missing some of them. Hold on. Ouch. Where art thou? Might be back here with the rest of them. No, these are just little slats. Okie dokie. Let's see. We have the two for the foldable one. You got two for the long big one. And I'm missing one piece here. Where is it? Where are you? Where are you hiding? It's not this thing. It's not going to be down here. At least I hope not. Where is that piece of wood? Missing a small stick. Where are you? Is it you? It might be. Let's see. Yep. Okay, here we go. So, if I could clamp this, that would be perfect, but I don't have hold downs, hold fasts that I could just put up against this. I could clamp it this way. That could be another option. Do this. Just needed to stay in place. While I route it out. So. Could put one here. On the bench. Cinch this down. Put this one up against it. Put this one on as another tear resistance surface or backing. And another clamp. Like that. Okay, and let's change out the blade. It's already disconnected, so that's good. There's our other monster bit here. And wrenches. We'll do a test cut first. I don't want to damage this. Okay, now we need our test piece, which is this. Let's just grab one of the smaller ones. And I do believe there's a thicker side. There's a thinner side. Again, it doesn't really matter as much as long as it's centered on there. These things never work as intended. Whenever you cinch it down, when you clamp it down, it moves ever so slightly always. You have to move it, cinch it, move it, cinch it, move it, cinch it, until you got it there, at least like halfway through. Okay, I said I wanted to do a test cut, so let's push this one back, actually. Let's just move this over. I have to watch out that doesn't fall on my foot. Oh, wait, and these actually have to go this way. Because these are actually, they go on the sides and they go like that, so. Let's try that again. Come on. Okay, let's see how this goes. Welcome in. Oh, nice. What's the point? What's the point? I don't even have to use this one. I need to grab a bigger block because this is not the best way to do this. gets all wibbly wobbly. And I have to cut these ends off. Yay! More work! More work. This means I have to take off the riving knife. Put in the drawer. This isn't it. Could use this small router. Hold on, let me see if I can. If I can kind of cheat it. I don't think I can though. Okay. Take care. Nope, I cannot. Bit is too thick. So, back to the drawing board. Remove the riving knife. Doesn't have to be that big, that tall. The problem is that the angle of attack is, it's pretty out there. It's gonna just blow out that end there. I have to change the blade. I don't want to. I could run them all through, like cut off this excess. A good thing I didn't do a full pass on it. Just have to really make sure which one is going to be the final death. Oh, I could check that out right now. I could set the table saw to score those ends on all the pieces. Let me see if this will clean up this little bump. If it doesn't, then I have to reset or make sure I have this set up right. And it did clean it up. So we are good. Okay. Yeah, it's just a matter of scoring it and then running it through the router bit. This would go on like that with blue. If not one way, then the other. Let's see. Yep, there we go. Okay. It's just a matter of adding glue afterwards. But now I have to do an extra step. The extra step is figuring out the depth of this. And setting the stop block there. Nine millimeters. So on all these pieces, have to score on each side 9 millimeters less. Okay, let's grab all our pieces. We have the four small ones. We have the four tall ones. These are the pieces that we have to work with. We have to notch out this side because they're on their sides like this. We have to cut off the ends. Yep, okay. Start with the itty bitty ones. These are what? I could mark 9 millimeters. To there and then measure it out. Why do I always do this the wrong way around? Two 265? 265? Yeah. Actually, it's 266. 266. I'll move the stop over. Welcome back, Life in Pain. Okay, let me just recheck that this is only going to score it and not necessarily clean it off. Don't really need to cut that deep. It could be somewhere around there just in case. Welcome back. Should probably change the blade. Not giving me the cleanest of cuts. Let's do that real quick, because last thing I need is for this to blow out one of these pieces and I have to redo them. Thanks for being here, man. This is not going to be a fun day for me.
Soka.
Height setting should stay the same. Oh, but I have to move it. No problem. Just do it. Yeah, I have to get it out of there. Hey! Hello there, Saucepan. How's it going? Hope you have a good weekend. I'm gonna have kind of a crummy one. Mostly due to this job, but at the very least, I have air conditioning in the room now. I had some problems. Plus, we had our water heater also not working, so I had an electrician yesterday and an air conditioning technician as well. so that maybe, just maybe, we could get a good night sleep last night. At the very least, I did have that, so I'm happy about that. Okay. Yeah, that's way better. Oh, but I also have to make sure it's in the same distance. Yeah, that did move a little bit because the kerf is thinner. So I have to reset this. 266 was it? Let's see if that's true. Huh? What? Oh no, did I do this wrong? No, no, we're good. Actually, we might even be off by a bit. Hold on, where is that piece? Yeah, we're off by quite a bit. And we're still off anyway. Let's see. This is. According to this, 265. If I burn 10 millimeters, it should say 275. It does. So. I should have to set this to 275. 265. Yeah, we're off by a millimeter. Can test it again if it still needs maybe a hair more. We can make it so that's 265, but like after the line. See here, that looks pretty good. If anything, we can just sand it off. Let's run this one through again. Where's our test piece? This wasn't it. Where is it? It's back here. I'm gonna fall here. Oh my god. Okay. Still off. So we could still nudge it ever so slightly. Let's do this again. And this is just for these four. That looks perfect. Okay. Flip it over. Do the other side. Welcome in. And these four are ready to be routed out. Let's just try and see if this will work. I also wanted to put maybe something a little more hefty against this. This is okay, but it's not the same height, which is the main problem. Let's see, how about you? Are you? Nope. Could put a clamp here. That could be a stop. Move this one a little further in. Let me get you guys to the back of the shop here, because I am a little far away. Okay, so this should work. And it did work, and it felt a lot more stable. Hey, what the? I won't break the seat though. Okay, I'll be right back, guys. Hey, there we go. Hey, sorry, I did not have a microphone on. The lavalier doesn't, of course, it doesn't have a way to tell me that I don't have batteries, but how's it going? Welcome in, Raiders. Thank you for the raid, Frugal Fixer. Hello there. What are we up to today? I'm sorry, I had my headset off. Battery ran out. How's it going? How was your stream? I gotta see if I can fix my earbud here. It's supposed. Sorry about that. There you go. Should be on now. I should have my other ear working. Yeah, sorry about that. So what were you doing? Tell us about yourself. I am Jesse. I am a woodworker from Puerto Rico. Welcome in. Yeah. Nice, nice. I am trying not to curse the day I was born with this crib. The irony is palpable, but I gotta fix this thing. I don't know if you can see here on the side, I have one of the frames for the crib itself, like the cage for that little crotch demon that's gonna be birthed onto this miserable planet. So I have to work my ass off today up until I can get all of it done. I have all the pieces cut. The worst part is the part of the footboard. I have to make that top arched part, and the slats have to have that arch profile as well. So yeah, that's going to be interesting. I have to make that happen. And it's really getting to me. But we are slowly but surely getting there. I'm cutting up the other pieces for the outer frame of the other sides. Welcome in. Hello. Welcome in. Welcome in, everybody. Nice to have you here. So yeah, I've been racking my brain as to how I'm gonna do this now, because I would have to have like three different templates. One for the outer edge of the arch, one for the inner edge of the arch, and then one for the inner edge inside the groove as well. Hey, Bibum! How's it going? How you doing, man? Thanks for being here. I'll fix the camera in a second. Hold on, I'll do that right now. But yeah, I've been just not having a great time with this build. Not particularly the build process, because the build process, you know, it's just a matter of just keep on hammering through until you get it done. But when you have a pregnant woman behind your ass, it's not fun anymore. Oh, nice. Okay. Well, then I'm glad you're here. Hope to see you guys again. You have to run out. That's completely understandable. I also wish I could just leave right now. I wish I could just close the shop and say, you know what, I'm not working no more today, because it is hot here. It's been hot ever since 9 a.m. It was just super hot here early on. So there's that. OK. Okay, hold on. Why aren't you leveling out? You should level out. There we go. Stay there. Cinch it over here. Four AM. Must be nice to not have bad neighbors. Okay. I'm gonna have to text my neighbor or let her know that I have to work up until late. Yeah, that could be another option. So yeah, this client has been up in my case with this thing, and you know, it's understandable. The baby's due next month, so it could just pop out at any moment. Who knows? It could be early. That could definitely happen. Oh, okay. So, I guess this is in the way now. The baby's due any moment. I haven't finished the bed. I know that babies don't typically sleep in their cribs the first nights. Hello there, welcome in. That was an interesting name. So I wish I could be further along than what I am right now. But, you know, you're like, oh yeah, I'll just route it out. In your brain, it makes complete sense to just pass the router through and have it work. But when the wood tells you, no, I don't work that way. Sure thing, I'll check you out. Hold on, let me just give you a shout out here real quick. My mod isn't in today, so let's do, hold on. So at Frugal Fixer, and I'll do Bibum as well. Let's see, who else is on? Well, thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you very much for the raid, guys. Hope I don't disappoint with my rants and ramblings here. Dissing on clients and stuff. Nah, I'm just kidding. But yeah, it is a little bit of a stressful situation here. So I say, oh, I'll just route it out, I go meow, and it's done. But oh, I'll add her as well. Her, him. I don't know what, but I'll add it as well. You could shout yourself out. I don't have it. I don't think I have it so that only mods do shout outs. So for now, I believe you guys could give me a hand with that, because I have to go back and forth here. This takes a little bit of time. Yes, thank you. Thank you very much.